Yo, what is going on, guys? This is your boy, MCRXFireShin. Today, we're diving into something very, very interesting, man. So, you guys saw it by the thumbnail, saw it by the title, and yes, we are talking about the Datamine DLC characters, all 9 DLC characters that have been datamined by no other than Sergio M3, man. Shout out to him, because he's been doing so many games, all the way from Shinobi Striker to Storm 4 to Xenoverse, man. He has been doing this for a long time and is a very reliable source when it comes to datamining games. So, let's hop right into the video. So, he did do a datamine on Jump Force, the PC version, and found some files and information for our 9 DLC characters. So if you do not know what he found in these files, it's gonna be Kaiba from Yu-Gi-Oh, Hitsugaya from Bleach, we're gonna have All Might, Biscuit from Hunter x Hunter or Hunter Hunter, however you like to say it, Boo from Dragon Ball Z, Katsuki Bakugo, Madara, Grimmjow, and Law from One Piece. Now that is just not what I expected at all. Where is Suna? Where is Madoka? Where are the other characters like Hiei that we wanted to have in the game? So this is very, very interesting that we don't have these characters that we really wanted to have within the game. Now, I know Kaiba is one that I personally wanted and something that was in my character roster video. I was not expecting Hitsugaya or even All Might because I expected just to have Bakugo within the game. So having All Might is just something that's going to be very, very weird to me because I thought, you know, Deku and Bakugo should be enough. And that kind of takes a spot from the Black Clover up, you know, that we could have had within the game. And then of course we have 2 wild cards being Boo and Biscuit, and that's just what the hell happened, man. Those are 2 characters I wouldn't have expected at all, really, and I don't want to see either one of these characters within Jump Force, to really be honest with you guys, especially not Boo. I'll give Biscuit a chance, but especially not fucking Boo. I hate Boo within Fighters already. I hate Boo. I hate Majin Boo. I hate Android 21. I hate Boo. I don't want to see any Boo characters or any Majin characters at that, unless you're giving us Majin Vegeta, and I don't even want that character within Jump Force. I really am not feeling that. Then of course, like I said, we have Bakugo, which we all expected to have within the game, and Madara is a fan favorite and another dope ass Naruto character we should have had in the game way over Kaguya. I don't care if Kaguya is your favorite villain or whatever, Madara was way better villain wise, way better combat, way better moves, way better jutsus. He was just an all around better hyped up character from the beginning of Naruto. Like, from the beginning of Naruto. And I feel like this character should have been in over Kaguya anyways. And of course, we have Grimmjow, which is another fan favorite character from Bleach. A lot of you guys really, really did want. And I feel like it's going to make a really good kind of a complex character to play as within Jump Force. And last but not least, again, with Law. Law, I feel like, was another character a lot of people asked for. A lot of people still really want to have Ace. But at the same time, you can kind of make Ace in the game, so I can see why we're not going to have him. But I feel like compared to my list here, and I'll have my list on the screen, I'll have the confirmed characters, man. Let me know in the comments down below, which version of DLC would you guys like more, my version or the actual version we're going to get for the game, man. And as well, make sure you guys let me know in the comments down below, what characters are you excited to play with out of the 9 characters that we actually have confirmed, man. I'm really, and when I say this, I'm really bummed that we're not getting Suna. Suna is one character I wanted very, very much, and we're not getting Suna. I am just, I'm so upset. I really wanted Suna in this game so badly. Suna would have been amazing in Jump Force, man, and this sucks. But guys, there is another way to get your fan favorite characters. I'm telling you, this is the only way, man. We have to support the first season of DLC. If they say, hey, we're actually getting support, they love this stuff, they love the characters, why don't we give them more? That is the only way we're possibly going to get a second season of DLC. That's why Xenoverse 2 strives and does so well, just because it's just being supported so much. So I feel like if we really, really want to have Suna, Hiei, Madoka, Gintoki, or Gintama, my bad, there's all these characters that we really want to have within the game, we have to support this DLC. But let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. First of all, let me know what you guys think of the DLC roster that we're actually going to have, and what characters you're going to use the most out of this DLC season pass, even if you're getting it. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next video. This has been your boy Infamous, and I am out.